Hey everyone, I'm your friend Pallavi from Find Inspiration. Welcome to my channel. I share videos related to DIYs, painting, bottle art, decoupage craft, home decor, etc. If you're watching my video for the first time or you're not yet subscribed my channel, please do consider subscribing for such more videos. And do not forget to hit the bell button to get the notification of my upcoming videos. So in today's video, I am going to share three different types of basket planters. Nowadays, you might have seen people using these baskets as planters. There are rope baskets, jute baskets, bamboo baskets, etc. I feel such basket planters are quite expensive when you go to purchase them. So I thought of doing a DIY. So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. For this DIY, here I am going to use these two placemats and I am using this cardboard which I have already cut according to the size of the placemats. So while choosing the cardboard, you have to take the full length, you should not cut it in between. Then here I am going to roll it. As I need a round shape, I am rolling the cardboard. Now join the two ends of the cardboard using a masking tape. While cutting the cardboard, I just placed the placemats and I just gave a cut, so I have not measured the measurement. If you don't have such type of placemats, you can also use some jute placemats or jute carpets, etc. So once the joint is secured, so it has taken a round shape, you can see that. So using Fevicol glue, I am going to stick this placemat to this cardboard. So I am going to stick it from both the sides. So one placemat we have already sticked. So let's stick the another one. To stick this placemat to the cardboard, you can take any type of glue. So after sticking, we will leave it to dry. Here I have used some cloth drying clips so that our placemat will stick to the cardboard properly. By that time, here I am using 3 strands of jute rope and I am making a braid. So we will stick it to the basket. So you can see there is a gap here and we will cover it using this jute rope. As you can see, I have not done any base for this basket. I'll show you how we can use such type of basket as a planter. So our basket is ready. Let's see how we can use it. As you can see here, this planter is looking so boring. This planter is so heavy that it will be difficult for me to lift. And here I'm going to place the basket from above. If your plant is big and it's not possible for you to put the basket from above, just keep the basket in the corner, place a plate and then you place your planter inside. As you can see, the boring planter is looking so beautiful in this corner after keeping it inside the basket. So let's move to our second DIY basket. So here I'm going to take this ceramic planter for the measurement and I'm using this canvas cloth material which is used in stitching. Here I am going to cut a round shape as a base according to the size of the ceramic planter. So you can see I have cut this keeping some extra cloth. And now I am going to measure the circumference and the length of the planter. According to that, I am going to cut the canvas. So here I have marked around 60 cm and 18 cm. So here you can see there are two pieces. So here I am going to place it in this way. I am using this fabric glue to stick the canvas cloth. Just cover the ceramic planter using this canvas cloth. Instead of ceramic planter, you can also use any containers which is available in your kitchen. So now we will stick the base. So here I am going to give a cut so that I can fold it properly. And once again, here I am going to apply this fabric glue and I will stick the base. So stick the cut ends all around the planter. So you can see we got the proper shape as a planter. So here I am using this cotton rope and jute rope, and by applying this fabric glue I am going to stick it. I have purchased this rope from a local hardware shop. You have to stick it in a circular pattern all around the base. As you can see, so here I am going to cut the jute rope, and only by using this cotton rope I am going to cover the whole surface. Here I did a mistake that I forgot to cover the ceramic planter with the plastic, because of which I removed whole basket, then applied the plastic cover and repeated the DIY once again. And sorry that I did not record that part. So here you can see that plastic cover which I have applied. So let's remove the basket. Only thing, if you apply the plastic cover, it will be very easy for you to remove the basket. You can remove the plastic easily, as here I am not going to take off the plastic as it will act as a waterproof for me. Our super easy rope basket is ready. So when we place some plant in this, it will enhance the look of the corner. Always keep a plate under a planter so that whenever you water the plant, the water will not run out. And as per your choice, you can make any size of such rope baskets. You can use these type of baskets in your living room so that you can decorate your corner by placing some indoor plants. Okay, now let's move to our third DIY. So here also I am going to take this type of cardboard. Whenever you buy something from Amazon, you will get such type of cardboard inside a big box. So here I am going to roll it properly so that I can make a proper round shape. And like this, I am going to make some marking measuring around 9 inches. And the rest of the space which is left, I am going to give a cut. After cutting it, just open the cardboard and you have to fold the edges like this. So here I am going to make the base for the basket. So once it is ready, I am going to take one more piece of cardboard and I'll just place it in this way and mark a circle. So I am using a steel plate to make a proper circle, and the diameter of the circle is 10 inches and the length or the depth of the basket is 9 inches. And I am going to cut two pieces of circle from this cardboard. And I am going to place one circle from inside the basket and another from outside. So first place the circle from inside, then you have to glue the edges, and then you have to stick the cut edges of the cardboard. So after sticking the edges properly, you have to again glue it and stick the another circle. To stick the cardboard, here I am using Fevicol MR glue. As you can see, the skeleton of our basket is ready. Here I am using this plastic bag and I am going to staple it inside the box so that I can make the basket waterproof. And we will cut the extra plastic according to the measurement. And here I am going to staple it from the sides and at the top of the basket. And I am going to repeat the same thing from the bottom. And by using a masking tape, I am sticking the edges of the plastic to the cardboard. By this, it will protect the cardboard from moisture. And I will cover the upper part also using the masking tape. And now here I am using this coir rope which I have purchased from a local hardware shop. And I will start sticking the rope to the cardboard. And to stick the rope, here I am using Fevicol MR glue. You can use any kind of glue like Heatex or the Fevibond or any other glue. Let's stick the coir all around the cardboard. I thought covering the cardboard half with coir and half with fabric. So I covered 1/4 part of the basket with fabric. To get a neat finish, here I am going to fold the fabric from inside and I'll stick it using glue. After sticking the fabric, I felt it will be good if I cover whole basket with the coir. So let's stick the coir all around the basket. And this is going to give a complete boho look for your basket. So at last, to secure the coir, here I am using this cloth tying clips, so by which the coir won't come out and it will stick properly to the cardboard. So just leave it to dry and finally our boho planter basket is ready. And here comes the final reveal. So you have to place a plant inside this, and this is how it's going to look. I just loved all the three basket planters. Among these three baskets, which is your favorite? Let me know below in the comment section. If you feel this video is helpful, then give your support and love by clicking the like button and subscribing my channel, and share the video with your family and friends. So friends, that's it for today. See you soon with one more interesting DIY video. Till then, take care and bye bye.